Welcome to Hong Kong. I would like to show you some of the fun, exciting, and interesting things you should know about Hong Kong. Hong Kong is a fascinating city, as many of the buildings have distinctive designs. You won't need a car to get around Hong Kong because Hong Kong has a wonderful transportation system. You will need an Octopus card, and you can get one at any service booth in any MTR station. If you keep the card for more than 3 months, you can get the 50 Hong Kong dollar deposit back. You can use your Octopus card on most transportation systems, as well as in various stores. You can recharge your Octopus card at any MTR station or at many stores around Hong Kong, such as Welcome Grocery Stores and 7-Eleven. You can also link your Octopus card to a Hong Kong-based credit card so it recharges automatically. The MTR runs all over Hong Kong, with one branch to mainland China and another to the airport. The Airport Express is the fastest and cheapest way to get to the airport, and you can check in your luggage at the Airport Express station in Central or Kowloon. The MTR is fast, clean, and polite.
Please stand back from the doors. Thank you for traveling on the MTR.
You rarely have to wait more than 3 minutes for the next train. From each MTR station, you will find a large selection of buses or taxis. All the large buses accept Octopus cards, as well as the small, green-top minibuses. The red-top minibuses only accept cash. Buses usually run every 15 to 20 minutes, however, there may be several buses headed past where you want to go. For instance, the 6, 6X, and 260 buses all go from Central to Stanley, but using different routes, so you rarely have to wait more than a few minutes for a bus. If a bus doesn't go exactly where you want, or you want to get there quickly and directly, the taxis are plentiful and cheap. The taxis only accept cash. A trip from Central to Stanley on the opposite side of Hong Kong Island will cost about 100 Hong Kong dollars in a taxi, where the bus will cost about 15 per person. A trolley system runs along the north side of the island. The fare to ride is 2 Hong Kong dollars, or about 25 US cents, for as far as you want to ride. It takes about 1.5 hours to travel the length of the rail. The Star Ferry Company runs a ferry system across Victoria Harbor to Kowloon. The ferries all have star names. The boats have propellers on both ends so they never have to turn around. The ride across the harbor is about 2 Hong Kong dollars. The seats flip back and forth so passengers can be headed forward, whichever direction that is. In the Central District and in Wan Chai, there are many covered overhead walkways that cut through buildings. Pedestrians can easily travel around Central without having to cross busy streets. It is possible to walk from City Tower next to Wan Chai all the way through Central to Western Market in Sheung Wan without stepping on a street. That's over a mile-long walk without having to dodge cars. The mid-level's escalator runs up the side of the mountain from Central. The escalator starts as a flat belt, then as the mountain becomes steeper, develops larger and larger steps. The escalator is composed of 18 sections with an altitude gain of approximately 450 feet over a distance of 2600 feet. The escalator runs downhill until 10 a.m., then is reversed and runs uphill for the rest of the day. The Lower Peak Tram Station is located across the street from the U.S. Consulate in the back of the St. John's Building. It is pulled up the mountain by a heavy steel cable. The morning is the best time to ride the tram because of the short lines to get on. The line to get on the tram grows as the day progresses. On a nice day, the line can grow to over an hour long by evening. Parts of the track obtain a 27-degree incline. The view of the city is gorgeous on a clear day or a clear night. But often pollution blows in from the mainland. Some days you cannot see the harbor from the peak. The air in Hong Kong is hot, rainy, and humid from May until September as the warm, moist air blows in from the ocean. November through February are cool and dry with breezes from the mainland that bring pollution and haze, but few clouds. Winters are about 60 degrees Fahrenheit, while summers are 85 to 90. On average, June is the rainiest month of the year. In June 2008, 51 inches of rain fell on parts of Hong Kong, breaking all previous records. Now that we know how to get around, let's explore Hong Kong. The tram station at the peak now charges $20 for access to the roof. Access to the roof of the mall across the street is free, and so are the telescopes. You will find the same view of Hong Kong from the mall roof, and an even better view to the west. Or walk east 200 feet to view the city from the pagoda, or 1,000 feet from Plantation Road. If you want to walk back to Central, Old Peak Road comes up to the tram station. Simply walk downhill and you'll end up back in Central. If you enjoy hiking, the islands and new territories are covered with a network of trails. The Hong Kong Trail begins at the peak and winds its way across the island to Big Wave Bay. The trail is approximately 30 miles long and divided into 8 sections. Much of the trail is paved, but there are some dirt and rocky sections. Section 5 is steep steps up and down, where Section 7 is almost completely flat. The Dragon's Back is not nearly as difficult as Section 5 and provides an excellent view of the eastern coast of Hong Kong Island. In Central, you will find Hong Kong Park and the Hong Kong Zoo. Both are free. You will find fountains and waterfalls in the park just like the rest of Hong Kong. There is a marriage registry in the park, so you will often see couples getting their photos taken around the park. There's a multi-level playground that's great for the kids, and a conservatory full of plants. The park also has a large aviary. Take your time going through the aviary, as many of the birds are hard to spot until they fly. The zoo is located between Central and Mid-levels. The largest animals the zoo has are orangutans. The zoo is divided by Albany Road. The birds are east of Albany Road, and the primates are west of it.